In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was over the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters. And God said, "Let there be light." And there was light.
The first time I saw sonar luminescence was in a darkened room. I was transfixed to look at this spherical flask of fluid.
And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the water.
A tiny spot of bright light contained in a flask of liquid.
And you look into the center, and in the center see a glowing blue-purple light, which could be seen with the unaided eye.
This star in a jar is made when a sound wave is passed through a small bubble inside a flask of liquid. And this sound wave, and this sound wave, this sound wave.
And God said, and God said, said.
And this collapse happens so violently that vapor molecules trapped inside the bubble slam together and heat up so much that the bubble gives off an incredible burst of heat and light, several thousand times a second, giving the appearance of a star.
These on.
Look, you crazy mother.
Put these on.
Hey! Stay away from me!
I'm telling you, you dumb son of a...
The Matrix is a system, Neo. That system is our enemy. When you're inside, you look around, what do you see? Businessmen, teachers, lawyers, carpenters. The very minds of the people we are trying to save. But until we do, these people are still a part of that system, and that makes them our enemy. You have to understand, most of these people are not ready to be unplugged. And many of them are so inert, so hopelessly dependent on the system, that they will fight to protect it.
Locked! Saying in Tennessee, I know it's in Texas, probably in Tennessee, that says, "Fool me once, Shame on you. It fooled me. We can't get fooled again.
And what you're seeing here is a mirage. We typically would not be able to see this from the Lake Michigan shore. We talked about this last night. Conditions are right on the lake, but we're actually seeing a mirage of the Chicago skyline.
But they are the gatekeepers. They are guarding all the doors, they are holding all the keys, which means that sooner or later, someone is going to have to fight them.
Thank you. surface on the ocean's floor was only just discovered in the 1990s. And my degree is one of a handful of people to ever see it in person.
Without a doubt, one of the most amazing things that I have ever seen in the bottom of the ocean. It was while filming for Blue Planet. It was in the Gulf of Mexico. I noticed there's something out in the distance. Couldn't tell exactly what, but it looked like a dark band. And as we approached it, the dark band became a donut. I saw this donut, and it was black in the center. What the heck is that? And so as we get closer and closer to it, I noticed that the black band had what appeared to be kind of steam over it. And then I looked, and there was water lapping against the shoreline. This band was a ring of mussels. And inside the ring of mussels was a lake. And it's like, wait a minute, I'm already underwater. And we went out over the water in this lake and tried to descend it and bounced off. It was so super saline and dense that the submarine couldn't go down it. We literally bounced off.
Fly those?
Absolutely.
Do you get to fly to the edge?
Oh, yeah.
What's past there?
Don't know. We're not allowed to fly past that.
Let's go.
It's against the rules, Jonas.
Who are you?
The Giver.
When the elders need guidance, I provide wisdom using memories of the past. Our world was different. There was more.
More?
Much more. There is no way for me to prepare you for the truth.
Thank you.
on the back of an old church pew. I learned to walk in the ways of light and truth, and I was told not to speak till I was spoken to. I heard it preach what I should and I should not do, and the choir sang. To be a good boy, but I ain't a boy no more. I've seen some things that a man just can't ignore, and this world's gonna see what I'm standing for. I've kept my peace, but I can't hold my tongue anymore.